The second part of the ECG is on the interpretation and taking a good ECG graphs, what are the different artifacts in ECG. So coming directly on the topic, we start with recording of the electrocardiogram or the ECG we call. So a recording of ECG is important in animal, as if the recording is done in a proper manner, we are very well easy, it is easy to us to appreciate the different changes on the ECG paper. For this, the most important one is the restraining and the positioning of the animals. As we see the different animals that comes to our clinic for ECG recording, the first and the basic step is how we put the animal on the table. You might have seen the table in the room number 3, that is our ECG room, where you have seen a wooden table is there, on which we have kept a leather covering on it, and we put the animal in a special recumbency, that is the right lateral recumbency. So this is the position for taking a good ECG. Now this, just you remember, the animal should be in the right lateral recumbency. Now after putting the animal on the right lateral recumbency, we have to keep all the 4 legs, that is the front leg and the hind leg, perpendicular to the body of the animal. So the most important thing is that you put the animal on the right lateral recumbency and the leg of the animal should be straight to the body and they are not touching with each other. So this is the first criteria for taking the ECG. So restraining and positioning of the animal is very, very important. But sometime, since we are taking ECG in case of canine and feline, they are not very much cooperative. And if the animals are not cooperative in taking ECG, it will create problem or it will produce artifacts. So for that, you have to take help of the owner also. So you ask the owner to hold the legs in a straight way and put its palm on the chest. Okay? So you ask the owner to hold the animal in the right lateral recumbency, put your owner's palms on the chest of the dog, so the dog remains in a lateral recumbency for a certain period of time. So, and if the animal still is not cooperating, sometime you have to sedate the animal. So you have to select certain drugs that is used before taking ECG. For example, you can give digipam at the dose rate of 1 mg/kg body weight before taking ECG, at least 1 hour before taking ECG. So you have to use a sedative drugs that does not interfere with the cardiac and the respiratory function. So that is very, very important. Yeah, if you take a drug and that interferes with the ECG, then you will be getting a false ECG. So that is used generally in the rare cases if the animal is not at all cooperating. Now coming to the electrodes, we have already seen the different electrodes of the ECG. Now the placement of electrodes, you might have seen where the electrodes are placed, you know, the 4 important electrodes are there and the 5th one is the chest electrodes. So you put the electrodes on the on the front leg at the caudal aspect of the olecranon process. So there is the olecranon process, and at the caudal aspect of the olecranon process, you put the electrodes and fixes with the help of an alligator. Wo chimte se usko attach kar dete hain. Similarly, in the hind legs, these electrodes are placed on the left and right limbs and attached at the patellar ligament. So this patellar ligament area is very, very important, and you attach the electrodes at the patellar ligament area. Now the special lead that is not always required, because we depends only on the lead 1, 2, and 3, and especially on lead 2. But if it is required, the placement is, you see the RV2, that is the lead, is placed at the 5th intercostal space near the edge of the sternum. Near the edge of the sternum at the 5th intercostal space at this region. Similarly, the V2 is placed at the 6th intercostal space near the edge of the sternum, and the V4 is at the left intercostal space at the costochondral junction. So this is important. And the V10, which is mostly generally this electrodes of the 5th lead is important and generally taken for a veterinary purpose and is taking ECG in canines. So V10 is generally placed over the dorsal spinous process of the 7th thoracic vertebrae. So these are the important lead attachment where you will place the lead. If the lead is placed properly, then you will be able to take a good ECG. Now, as in other instrument, each and every instrument has some problem in taking some interference with the environment, some interference with the machine, some there may be problems, some mechanical problem, or man-made error occurs. So in case of ECG also, there are chance of creeping of artifacts during ECG interpretation or during ECG taking in the dog. So the very important artifact, because if you are not able to appreciate this artifact, sometimes it interferes with your interpretation. So these artifacts are very, very important. And the most important one is the electrical interference. Now you see the electrical interference and there is a graph on your PPT. You see, this is a R wave, this is R wave, this is R wave. And in between the R wave, there are different spikes. Just like this, spikes are called 60 cycle interface. So these are the electrical interference. So these interferences are produced because when the animals are used on a table on which there is no insulating rubber like covering is there, or if the animal is bearing a belt, bearing a chain or a belt of iron in nature, or there is some instrument with a AC current is running near the ECG machine. So all these interference comes and they produce a disturbances in ECG machine. And on the paper, you find a 60 spikes like, just like a, you see the raw tooth-like or you saw-like tooth-like structure finding 60 structure ups and downs curves you find on the ECG graphs. So this is an artifact. And if this artifact is coming, it is very, very difficult to take the good ECG graphs. Now there is again a very important artifact, and sometimes people misinterpret that something is abnormal in the cardiac regions. You see the ECG is normal here. You see the P graph and QRS and again T wave, and then the wave is coming and suddenly you see a spikes. It is visible. So these are the spikes produced by the muscular movement. As I told, the positioning and restraining of the animal is very, very important. But when the animal start shaking its head, when the animal starts shaking its legs, so in that, if the animal is shaking their body, or there is a vibrating, or the muscle is vibrating and showing some movement on the table during the ECG procedure, so it will produce again sharp line on the ECG paper. And this is, you see like a big spikes at a one region of the ECG. This indicate that the animal is showing a movement during the ECG procedure, and it will produce a spikes like at the on the baseline of the ECG paper. So these two very, very important artifacts. The first is the electrical interference, and second is the muscle tremor artifacts. Now, third very important artifact, and we usually encounter this artifact during our ECG procedure in our clinics also. And there are so many regions of getting this. This is called a bandering baseline artifact. Now you see that a good ECG should have a regular ECG running in a straight line. It just should be in a straight line. But if the animal is not cooperative, if the animal is showing distress, if the animal is showing coughing, or if the animal is suffering from some problem in which the animal is unable to lie on a external recumbency, in that condition, the ECG is not running on a single straight line, and it will float. It's just like a floating, wandering here and there. The baseline is wandering on the graph. So this is called a baseline wandering graph. You see here on the it's a straight line is coming, and then it is coming down, and then it is coming up. So this is called a wandering baseline, and it is due to so many factors. It may be due to non-application of gel on the electrodes or on the body, or there is some interference, especially the animal is not cooperative, the table is not insulated. So these are the conditions, or the animal is not lying down properly, or there is a problem in the postural change in the body. So in that condition, the wandering baseline type of artifacts comes on the ECG paper, and these types of artifact interferes with our interpretation of taking a good ECG. Now coming to the most important one, that is really it will give you a clue to how to get a good ECG graphs and how to get a good interpretation. Now, starting from the first, this you are showing here, and this T wave is here on your ECG graphs, and it indicates something. After P wave, there is a QRS complex and the T wave. So my first question is from you, what is the P wave? Can anyone tell me? Hello?
Depolarization of both atria.
Very good. Both atria means at both the right and left atrials. Okay. So most of you are knowing, so I'm just revising this. The P wave is the wave that originates, that indicates the depolarization of both auricles, left and right auricles. And this is indicated as a small, small elevated curve on the ECG paper. Now it indicates the depolarize, the first part of the P wave, the first part. You see there are two parts, one is ascending, another is descending. The first part of this P wave indicates depolarization of right atrium. And the second part of this P wave, that is the descending one, indicate the depolarization of the left atrium. You see here. So all of you are visualizing this. There is no problem in ECG, in the P wave. Everyone understand this P wave? Okay. Now I'm proceeding to the next one. So the P wave indicates depolarization of both atrium. Means here, the depolarization of right as well as left atriums. So another very important point, after depolarizations, it means the waves will depolarize, will come out from the SA node of from the right auricle, and it spread to the left auricle. So there is a little gap in depolarization of the left right auricles and the left auricles. Now after depolarization of the whole auricular muscle, the speed, the waves start moving towards the AV node. You need see at the base of the right aurea, left and right auricles, there is an AV node. AV node, the all the waves reaches at the AV node. So there is a difference in the speed of the wave in the auricles and in the AV node. The speed of generally the wave in the auricle is 500 millimeter to 1000 millimeter per second. And that in the AV node, it reduces to 100 millimeter, 50 to 100 millimeter per second. So you see, there is a big decrease in the rate of the move of these waves in the AV node in comparison to SA, the SA node, or in comparison to auricular muscle. So that is represented by a very, very important part that is called a PR segment. So it indicates the movement of the wave from the auricular muscles into the AV node up to the bundle of Hayes is called PR segment, is indicated by a PR segment. So you see here a best flat line. Just after elevation of P wave, just after the formation of a P wave, at the end of this P wave, you find a flat line. You see here a flat line. This is called PR segment. And this PR segment is important because it indicates the wave is moving from AV node to the bundle of Hayes. So this is the region from where you get an isoelectric point. So this is called a isoelectric point. This is the first line that is flat. That is flat after the P wave. So this is the first line that is flat in nature, and this is called PR segment. Why I'm telling each and every, because later on, you will be able to appreciate the P wave amplitude and the time, and also we will be able to appreciate the PR segment. So you understand the PR segment? So this is the PR segment. So this is different from PR interval. PR segment is different and PR interval is different. PR interval is the total time starting of the P wave up to the end of this wave. Here, starting of the Q wave is the PR interval. But PR segment is just the delay in the conduction of the impulse from. So QRS complex, everyone understand, this is the ventricular depolarization. The Q is the first negative deflection and R is the first positive deflection. And again, S is the second negative deflection. So two negative deflection and one positive deflection form a QRS complex. Now next question again to
sir,
you.
Sir, एक मिनट question है सर यहाँ पे.
Yes, yes.
So doubt है एक सर.
Yeah.
Sir, एक बार फिर से repeat कर दीजिए सर. क्यों सर negative deflection क्यों थोड़ा कट गया था सर मेरा उस time पता नहीं चला सर.
Oh, कट गया था.
थोड़ा सर repeat कर दीजिए.
अच्छा, मैं वो तो graph भी back जाना पड़ेगा रुको. Just wait. यहाँ पे मैंने एक graph बताया था. Yeah, here. Q wave is negative deflection. This is again a very good question. And why some wave become positive and why some wave become negative? So the first answer is that if the wave is moving towards the positive pole, ठीक है? Towards anode की ओर move कर रहा है, जैसे ऐसे anode से पूरा ये पूरा wave इधर की ओर जा रहा है, okay? ये देख रहे हैं मेरा cursor? पूरा wave इधर की ओर जा रहा है, पूरा wave. लेकिन AV node पे आ करके इतना ये पूरा जो region है यहाँ यहाँ से wave नहीं pass करता है, ध्यान रखिएगा. ओके सिर्फ वेव यहीं से यही एक जगह है, एक तार है एक से. ओके एवी नोड अभी मैंने बताया था कि स्पीड यहाँ पे बहुत ज्यादा होता है, स्पीड 10 टाइम्स घट जाता है यहाँ पे स्पीड. लेकिन ये यहाँ से बंडल ऑफ फिज निकलेगा, ओके है ना, लेफ्ट एंड राइट बंडल ब्रांच एंड देन द प्रोकेंजी फाइबर्स, तो फिर यहाँ पे स्पीड बढ़ जाता है 1000 के आसपास में, 2000 आ जाता है यहाँ पे. ओके 1000 के आसपास में तो वहां से स्पीड बढ़ेगा. तो इनिशियल जो डिपोलराइजेशन वेव बंडल ऑफ हीज में है उसका जो नेट डिफ्लेक्शन है, नाउ डिफ्लेक्शन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, उसका जो नेट डिफ्लेक्शन है वो नीचे नहीं जाता है बिकॉज बंडल ऑफ हीज ऐसे है नीचे की ओर है और इसको दोनों ऑरिकल्स को डिपोलराइज करना है. ओके तो ये वेव पहले ऐसे पास करेगा, ओके ये वेव इसके परपेंडिकुलर पास करता है, यहाँ पे एनोड लगा है, ओके एनोड की ओर अभी नहीं जा रहा है, अभी नीचे इस तरह से नहीं फैल रहा है वेव, अभी ये वेव यहां से ऐसे हो गया. ओके तो उसके डिफ्लेक्शन के तरफ नहीं होने के कारण ये छोटा सा निगेटिव देता है और बहुत जल्दी ही पूरे ऑरिकल्स को वेंट्रिकल को डिपोलराइज कर लेता है, तो फिर ये वेव नीचे की ओर फैलने लगता है इस तरह से. ओके समझ रहे हैं, जब नीचे की ओर फैलने लगेगा तो फिर वो उसका जो मूवमेंट है नेट डिफ्लेक्शन टुवार्ड्स पॉजिटिव पोल हो जाते हैं, इसी कारण से एक बार वो निगेटिव होके फिर पॉजिटिव की ओर चला जाता है.
सर 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 इट सर तब तक ही नेगेटिव रहेगा जब तक सर प्रोकिंजा फाइबर में है सर.
हाँ वहां से वेव जब निकल जाता है तो पूरा जब वेंट्रिकुलर मास में चला जाएगा तो वेंट्रिकुलर मास में पूरा
आर वेव स्टार्ट हो जाएगी ना सर.
आर वेव स्टार्ट, इसलिए वेंट्रिकुलर मास इतना ज्यादा है तो आर वेव पॉजिटिव के तरफ बन जाता है. ओके हम कहां पे थे, ओके हम लोग एक एक्सरसाइज कर रहे थे अभी, पी वेव देख लिया. ओके आप लोग रेडी रहिएगा बताने के लिए ना. QRS complex is over. So the next is J point. I just give a clue of J point. J point nothing but S wave. So
yes, wave. Yes.
हाँ कहाँ पे J point कहाँ पे बन सकता है? J के हम English letter के J के तरह बनेगा.
End of the QRS complex sir.
S wave से नीचे आएगा ना.
End of QRS complex. Sir.
Very good.
Yes. Sir.
End of the QRS complex. QRS complex आपने एक बड़ा सा देखा और जहां पे end करेगा कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि नीचे जाए. Okay? नीचे जा रहा था S wave बन रहा था, अगर यहीं पे हो जाए, कभी कभी बहुत जल्दी से शुरू हो जाता है दूसरा वेव, तो जैसे ही ये फ्लैट लाइन से मिलेगा जो एक वेव नीचे की ओर आ रहा है, एक वेव ऐसे आ रहा है और एक वेव ये इसको फ्लैट होना है यहाँ पे टी वेव बनने के लिए, तो ये दोनों के जो मिलने वाला जगह है देखिए अंग्रेजी का जे की तरह बनेगा. ओके देयरफॉर इट इज कॉल्ड जे पॉइंट, यू सी हियर. सो एंड ऑफ द क्यूआरएस कॉम्प्लेक्स इज द साइट ऑफ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ जे पॉइंट. सो दिस पॉइंट इज अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई विल गिव सम क्लू अबाउट इफ द जे पॉइंट फॉर्मेशन इज वेरी वेरी अर्ली इट इंडिकेट सम कार्डियक प्रॉब्लम. नाउ एसटी सेगमेंट, so ST segment is again important. The elevation of the ST segment, the flat line. आपने एक PR segment देखा और एक दूसरा flat segment आप देख रहे हैं ECG के curve पे, that is ST segment. And this ST segment in the period of phase 2 action potential, जिस तरह से वो isoelectric formation यहाँ पे हुआ था, फिर वहां पे थोड़ा सा impulse का problem होता है, कमजोर पड़ता है क्योंकि वो एक बार ventricle अब repolarization की ओर move कर रहा है तो डीपोलराइजेशन से, तो वेव एक बार बढ़ने इतना ऊंचा वेव हुआ था बना था वो एक बार अब घटेगा और तब जाकर के फिर से ऑरिकल डीपोलराइजेशन को इंडिकेट करेगा, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड ए एसटी सेगमेंट एंड इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय ए फ्लैट लाइन. नाउ द टी वेव, सो इट इंडिकेट्स ए वेंट्रिकुलर मसल
डीपोलराइजेशन.
सो दीज आर द बेसिक्स And again, I am coming is the QT interval. Now we have seen the T interval. Now is the QT interval is the total time of ventricular depolarization and repolarization. जिस तरह से PR मैंने discuss किया था कि total time of auricular depolarization as well as delay in the passing of the impulse from AV node to the bundle of phase is called PR interval. Therefore, here also the QT interval is the total time of ventricular depolarization and the repolarization. So it is a cumulative of depolarization and the repolarization. Now, this is a type of exercise. What are the different interpretation we can make from a ECG paper? अभी मैंने एक ECG लिया किसी एनिमल का और उसको आपके सामने रख दिए. आपको देख करके क्या पता चलेगा? Or you can calculate something very very important factors from it. The most important one is the heart rate. You can calculate the heart rate from a ECG. No need of going for examination and no need for going for counting of the pulse. From the very ECG paper, you can calculate the heart rate of the animal. So this is the formula for you. This formula is calculate the how you will calculate the heart rate. So count the number of complexes square in 3 seconds. Okay, but the most important factor again here is that you just keep in mind that the paper speed is 25 millimeter per second. Because when you will change the paper speed, the formula will change. So I am telling here that at 25 millimeter per second, you count the number of square in 3 seconds. Okay. So one grid or one box, you know, at 25 millimeter per second on ECG paper is equal to 0.04 second. So just divide 3 seconds by 0.04 second. It will make 75 small box. 75. Okay. पिछले क्लास में मैंने बताया था कि एक बड़ा सा जो ग्रिड है, बड़ा सा जो लाइन है, आप देखेंगे इसी पेपर पे हॉरिजॉन्टल में भी और वर्टिकल में भी, उसके बीच में कितने छोटे छोटे ग्रिड होते हैं?
पांच.
ओके,
फाइव.
तो बड़ा बड़ा बॉक्स कितना आ जाएगा? 75 स्मॉल बॉक्स हो गया. उसको आप 5 से डिवाइड कर दीजिए. बात समझ रहे हैं कि नहीं मेरा? 75 टोटल बॉक्स. इस तरह से 75 छोटे छोटे बॉक्स आपको काउंट करने हैं. उतना नहीं काउंट करके आपको पता है कि एक बड़े वाले ग्रिड में हर 5 के बाद एक मोटा सा लाइन है, हर 5 के बाद एक मोटा सा लाइन है. तो आप चाहे तो 15 बड़े बड़े ग्रिड को काउंट कर लीजिए या फिर 75 स्मॉल ग्रिड को काउंट कर लीजिए उस ईसीजी पेपर पे. यहां से स्टार्ट करके यहां तक काउंट कर लीजिए. अब उसमें देखिए कि कितना कॉम्प्लेक्स आर वेव बना है. कोई एक कॉम्प्लेक्स को चूज कर लीजिए. तो आप आर वेव को चूज कर लीजिए. उसमें इतने 75 बॉक्स के बीच में सपोज करिए कि आपको कुछ मिला है. आपको मान लिया 7 मिला है या 8 मिला है या 9 मिला है, कुछ भी एक काउंटिंग मिल गया. ओके, 7 मिल गया है. अब इसको गुना कर दीजिए एक फैक्टर से 20 से. इट्स अ वेरी इजी मेथड. यू कैन कैलकुलेट द हर्ट रेट. सपोज करिए कि 15 लार्ज बॉक्स में आपको 8 मिल गया और तब कितना हर्ट रेट हो गया उस एनिमल का? 160 जो भी हो. अब जब भी आएगा, आप कुछ हम जान नहीं रहे हैं. जब आप ईसीजी अगला हम आपको एक एक्सरसाइज दे रहे हैं, आप जितना जल्दी हो इसको बनाइए. मैं अगला, नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज एक्सरसाइज. सो यू कैलकुलेट द हर्ट रेट फ्रॉम दिस पेपर. एनीवन, द आई गिव यू अ क्लू. यहां से आप एक ईसीजी पेपर है, यहाँ पे आप ईसीजी ग्राफ देख रहे हैं. इसको देख करके आप इससे एक हर्ट रेट कैलकुलेट करके हमें बता दीजिए. जल्दी, बहुत इजी है. ये देख रहे हैं यहां पे 15 बॉक्स गिन लीजिए. 15 बॉक्स के अंदर में आर ग्राफ गिन लीजिए. काउंट टोटल नंबर ऑफ आर एम्पलीट्यूड इन दिस 15 बॉक्सेस. Just multiply it by 20. Quick. कितना हुआ बॉक्स?
240. 12 है सर. 12 पे
12 है.
12 सर, 200 होगा.
ओके, ठीक है. आप किसी
200 आ रहा है.
ओके ठीक है, आप कोई 10 गिन लेगा तो 200 आ जाएगा, कोई 11 गिन लेगा तो 200 से उतना 210 आ जाएगा, ठीक है। सो आई थिंक यू विल बी एबल टू डू दिस एक्सरसाइज इजिली। नाउ द नेक्स्ट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज द रिदम ऑफ द हार्ट। यू नो द रिदम इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड एरिथमिया इज वन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम बोथ इन ह्यूमन बींग एज वेल एज इन कैनाइन। सो देर इज नो नीड ऑफ इवन counting something in case of arrhythmia and no need of any formula. Just by visualizing the ECG paper, you can tell that this animal is suffering from arrhythmia. So you see here, you see on the graph paper, the distance between the RR interval. Therefore, on the previous slide, I told that you see the RR interval is very, very important. So if the equal RR interval is coming on the ECG paper, the heart is in rhythm. Okay?
Rhythm.
So if there is irregular means the RR interval is increasing or decreasing or variable, it is called arrhythmia. So there is a problem in the rhythm. You see here, there is a graph on this. Sometime 4 square is coming, sometime 2 square is coming, sometime 5 square is coming. This is an indication that animal is suffering from arrhythmia. So on the next slide also, there is an exercise for you. Can you tell me where there is arrhythmia? Is it a normal ECG or there is a regular R wave is there, or there is certain point on the ECG where there is irregularity of rhythm is there?
Certain point, sir.
Yeah, sir. बहुत ध्यान से देखना इसको. इसमें दोनों चीज मिक्स है,
yes, sir.
रिदमिक भी है और एरिदमिक भी है, मतलब नॉर्मल हो रहा है, एरिदमिया भी हो रहा है। ओके आई एम गिविंग द क्लू, जस्ट टेक ए नोट ऑफ दिस।
सर फर्स्ट फोर एंड लास्ट फोर जो है,
अभी देखा आपने, एक गया उस पे
कर्सर, फर्स्ट कॉर्नर एंड लास्ट कॉर्नर,
यस
यस सर,
एट द बिगनिंग एंड एट द एंड। So, मैं उसको कर्सर से आपको इंडिकेट कर रहा हूँ। पहला आपने इंडिकेशन देख लिया, दूसरा इंडिकेशन आपने देख लिया, देयर इज अ बिग गैप, है ना, गैप वहां पे आर आर इंटरवल के बीच में। नाउ अगेन यू सी द स्टार, एक गैप देखा आपने, बॉक्सेस देखा, यहाँ पे लगभग 11 बॉक्स लग रहा है हमें, 11 बॉक्सेस का लग रहा है स्मॉल ग्रिड। नाउ अगेन यू सी हियर, सो यू कैन वेरी वेल एप्रिसिएट इफ द एनिमल इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम एरिडीमिया by seeing the ECG paper, by seeing the RR interval, we can appreciate this irregularities in heart beat. So this is a ready reckoner, okay? So there is no need of worry about this. It will gives the clue. Actually, you have to remember, or sometime you just keep a record on, if you are taking an ECG, just you note it down on your register, on your copy or in a diary, and make it as a ready reckoner, because it is very, very difficult to remember all these seconds and the normal millivolt. But the sometime you can remember few things like the amplitude of the P wave. So this is the heart rate you see, and you see the R wave amplitude here. It is R wave amplitude is generally 0.9 to 2.8 millivolt. Okay, so you know that one small box is 0.1 millivolt, or one big grid is, or the 10 will form 1 millivolt. You see in a small or the large animal, so this is the normal value of the amplitude of the R wave. Also, the distance on the Y axis is measured in seconds. So you see one grid is equal to 0.04 second. So on the basis of the number of seconds, it is calculated, and this is the normal you see here. So no need of repeating all this. This is the baseline depression and elevation. And from this comparison, from this chart, we will able to appreciate if the animal is suffering from certain types of any cardiac disease. So you see, I'm just coming to one by one. If there is abnormality in P wave, you just concentrate on the P wave. So you see the P wave amplitude and the P wave duration, that is in second. If it is broad, means the if normal should be less than one box, or the less than two box, one box generally. If it is more than one box, you know the one box is 0.04 second. इट्स अ ब्रॉडर. अगर वो चौला हो जा रहा है पी वेव, इट इज इंडिकेटिंग अ लेफ्ट एट्रियम एनलार्जमेंट, ओके, और द पी मिट्रल इट इज कॉल्ड. Or if it become taller, if the P wave is generally, P wave is very, very short. If it is less, if it is around four boxes, four small box, 1.1 millivolt, 0.2 millivolt, 0.3 millivolt, 0.4 millivolt. If it is greater than 0.4 millivolt,